Welcome, my dear listeners. I'm Asma Rizkalakli, an assistant teacher, English 9th School College, Rangpur. I hope that you all are well and you are following the videos and learning your lesson regularly. Dear students, you know that we are learning tense and we have already finished lot of tenses. And today we will again learn tense, and today's learning outcomes are writing sentences according to tense, changing sentences in different forms, and also making the expression. After learning this tense, you can easily make sentences with this tense, and you can also change different forms. Okay, change a sentence in different forms. So which tense will you learn today? Just guess. Past perfect tense. Today, I will discuss about past perfect tense. Students, past perfect tense, where we can use past perfect tense. Past perfect tense is used in the former action between two completed actions in the past. Listen carefully. Between two completed actions in the past, two actions have been already completed in the past, and the former action, the action which has already been finished or which has finished past, this action will be in past perfect tense, and the latter action will be in past indefinite tense. So, former and latter, these two actions have already been completed in past, and the former action will be in past perfect tense. Okay, students, and the latter action will be in past indefinite tense. I will make it clear with examples. Okay, so structure. Before going to examples, we have to learn this structure nicely. Subject plus had plus main verb in past participle form plus extensions. That is here an auxiliary verb and main verb will be in past participle form. Okay, students, look at the examples. The train had started before they reached the station. Here is two actions. First, the train had started and then they reached the station. But this action had finished first. The train had started. Okay, before. Before is here a conjunction. To make this tense clear, we have to use before and after and another conjunctions also to make differences between these two actions. Okay, let it more clear. Look at the picture. The passenger is late. Okay. And the passengers are late here and the train is going. So these two actions, just case, these two actions have already finished in the past. The train had started before. The train had started before and the passengers reached the station. So they could not get into the train because train had already started, which is the first action in past. Okay, and they reached the station in they are in they cannot get into the train. Okay, because they are late. The train had already started. Next, they had reached the school before the bell rang. What happened in our school if the bell rang? The gateman closes the gate, but they reached first. They had reached first at the school and then the bell rang. Okay, so this is the former action. They had reached the school. Next, the patient had died before the doctor came. The patient had died. This is the former action. Before the doctor came. Okay, the patient died first, then the doctor came. So this is the former action, and this action will be in past perfect tense. The patient had died before. We watched a movie after we had eaten our dinner. So after is here another conjunction, and past perfect tense is used. Past perfect tense is used after after. Okay, I will make it clear. When you use past perfect tense, where and where you used past perfect tense, if the sentence is in these two conjunction, I will make it clear. So they had first eaten their dinner and then they watched a movie. So their eating dinner is the former action. So the sentence, we watched a movie and we had eaten our dinner. They had first eaten their dinner. Okay. I had done my exercise when he came to see me. When is here another conjunction, and he came to see me. This is the later action, but first action, I had done my exercise. Okay. Student, using of before and after. I have said that I will make it clear, okay, about this conjunction. I will use some Bangla here to make it more clear. Before. Before means purbe. So, before er purbe habe past perfect tense. Before er pore habe past indefinite tense. Again, before means purbe. Purbe means age. So, before er age habe past perfect tense. Before er pore habe past indefinite tense. Again, after means pore. So, after er pore habe past perfect tense. After er age habe past indefinite tense. You just remember that after means pore, so pore habe past perfect tense. Before means purbe, so purbe habe past perfect tense. Before er age habe past perfect tense. So in these two side, there will be past indefinite. Okay. Students, there are also some other that we can use past perfect tense. That these are since, as, because, when, till, until, that, as if. Okay, I am giving you example so that you can easily understand. Annie had lived in a cottage since she was born. Since theke. Okay, since she was born, Annie had lived in a cottage. I returned home as I had not locked the room. As means jehetu. Okay, I returned home as I had not locked the room. I called him because I had promised to help him. Because Karol, I had promised to help him. Okay. He had learned nothing when he was at school. Jokhon. When means jokhon. He had learned nothing when he was at school. He refused to go. Until jottokkhon porjonto na, he had seen all the pictures. He refused to go. He don't wait till we had finished our meal. Till means porjonto. He did not wait till we had finished our meal. He said that he had been in India for 10 years. He had been in India for 10 years. Students, we have to use this conjunction in this way. And here you look, every conjunction has taken past indefinite with past perfect. Past perfect with past indefinite. Perfect with past indefinite. Okay, you can understand easily. These conjunctions are also used in past perfect tense, past indefinite tense also. Thank you, students. I hope that you clearly understood. He pretended as if nothing had happened, as if jeno, nothing had happened. Again, past indefinite, past perfect. You can use this form Okay, when you will go in other classes, you have to use these conjunctions. Okay, in upper classes also. So you learn tense in this way, and I think that it will be very easier for you. Next. Past perfect tense in different forms. I have already told you, and I have already shown you that we have to learn tense in different forms also. What is past perfect tense in interrogative form? What is past perfect tense in negative form? What is past perfect tense in interrogative negative form? These are most important things. So, I had worked sincerely. This is an affirmative sentence. And this is in past perfect tense. I had worked sincerely. So to make a sentence negative, you know, we have to use auxiliary verb after the subject with not sign, with negative sign. Okay, because we are making it negative. With negative sign. Subject plus auxiliary verb plus not plus main verb plus extension. Okay, students. Because I have said that had is here, auxiliary verb. So we have to write not with auxiliary verb after the subject. This is the main thing. After the subject, we have to use auxiliary verb with negative sign to make a sentence negative. Look at the examples. I have not worked sincerely. Then we will make it interrogative. To make it interrogative, we have to use auxiliary verb before the subject. It is the general rule. You have to use this formula in every tense. Okay. So, auxiliary verb before the subject. Then main verb plus extension. And you have to put question mark at the end of the sentence because we are making it interrogative. Look at the sentence. Had I worked sincerely? Then interrogative negative. Interrogative sentence but with negative meaning. First, we have to use auxiliary verb plus not plus subject plus main verb plus extension. As I have already told you that you have to put auxiliary verb before the subject to make a sentence interrogative. It is a general rule. Okay. Hadn't I worked sincerely? So, making WS question. I have put underline here sincerely. So to make a question, WS question, you have to use WS word before the subject. Before the subject, auxiliary verb. Before the subject, then main verb plus extension. How had you worked? How had you worked? So students, these are the forms. Form that you have to understand or you have to make it yourself. Okay, while practicing tense. Next. Homework. I have given you some sentences for practice. Okay. You should follow the video and you should follow the rules and make these three sentences into negative, interrogative, interrogative, negative, and WS question. Okay. And I have not put any underline. These words you will make WS question. You try yourself. This word you will choose and how you will make the WS question. And you can make more WS question with a sentence. Okay. You can make WS question as much as you can. You take different words from a sentence and make WS question one by one. It will be very helpful for you. Okay, you yourself make WS questions and send me on comment box. And students, if you face any difficulties, you of course, you definitely comment me. I will try my best to solve your problem. Okay, students, hope you will be safe and sound and you will learn your lesson regularly. Till then, Allah Hafiz.